Hey everybody, welcome back to another video here on the Washington Football Maniacs channel. My name is Greg Sykes. Welcome if you're new here. And if you don't mind, please consider subscribing to this channel as I try to come out with videos on a regular basis. When you do subscribe, make sure that you hit that notification bell so you'll never miss another video released here on the Washington Football Maniacs channel. With that said, let's get into today's video. I'll try to keep this one short, but let's talk about Thursday night's matchup against the Chicago Bears. Now, the Washington Commanders are traveling to Chicago Thursday night to take on the 2-3 Chicago Bears. The Chicago Bears open up as a 1-point favorite over the Washington Commanders. No surprise there whatsoever. The Chicago Bears will be getting back K'Neil Harry, one of their wide receivers who had been out on IR since training camp. He had messed up his ankle. They'll be getting him back. Now, Harry, he's pretty good with run blocking as well as, of course, you know, being a wide receiver. So, let's see what happens with that, because as we know, we're looking at a dual threat quarterback here with Justin Fields. Fields, from what I understand, he's making some progress as a quarterback. You know, hey, what can I say? It's one of those teams where he's kind of been thrown in the fire a little bit. But, from what I've heard, there's a little bit of inaccuracy with his passing. But, I mean, you know, he's a young quarterback. He's going to learn, but he looks like he's leading his team. I mean, right now, the Chicago Bears are 2-3. So if they beat the Commanders Thursday night, they're back to 500. So certainly, they're not playing badly. You know, they kind of dug themselves into a hole against the Minnesota Vikings this past Sunday, and they came back. And, of course, you know, Kirk Cousins did his Kirk Cousins thing, and the Vikings pulled the game out. But the Bears are not a bad team. They are a team that is right now, they're basically at best, they're a 500 team. But, you know, they are a team that I think is only up and up. They have had a few issues, I think, in play calling as well. And they've had some miscues, of course, with wide receivers and inaccuracies with Justin Fields. But for the most part, you know, this is going to be a tough game for the Washington Commanders, I think. You know, the Commanders are going to have to start off fast in this game. You know, just like they did against the Jacksonville Jaguars, they're going to have to do something they don't do normally this season. They're going to have to come out and score touchdowns, right? I know that's kind of a foreign thing for this Commanders team, but they're going to have to come out and they're going to have to score some touchdowns. They're going to have to control the clock. They have not been getting that done here lately because they haven't been running the football. Scott Turner's going to have to understand that if you want to win football games, you have to have a balanced offensive attack, right? You can't just sit back there, have Carson Wentz take over the ball game, because with that offensive line, it's not holding up. It's not been very good with pass protection. So you're going to have to start running the football, which means the offensive line, again, they're going to have to figure out some ways of being able to open up some running lanes. And, you know, honestly, that offensive line, outside of Charles Leno, has not been good at all, especially that interior. That interior is awful. So, you know, for Washington, they're going to have to do something. They're going to have to start forcing the running game as much as they possibly can. Take some pressure off of Carson Wentz. You know, they're going to have to do something with that in order to win this football game. And honestly, I think that if they continue the play calling like they have, they're going to continue to lose football games. You know, it's kind of like this for some of you young guys who were never around during the glory years, and this was a little bit in my youth, so it's kind of sketchy with me when I first started watching football. But in Joe Gibbs' first year as head coach of the Washington Redskins, the team started off, they were high-flying. He brought in that Don Coryell offense, They were high flying. Joe Theismann was throwing his long bomb passes downfield to his wide receivers. I mean, it was an exciting offense to see. But they started off 0-5. Why? Because they just really didn't have, too much of a balanced offense. And Gibbs and company had to come in and they had to scrap what they were doing. They had to say, look, we need to start controlling the clock, controlling the game. We can't allow the other team to come on the field and score points too. And so that's when you started seeing a little bit more of John Riggins. You started seeing more of a balanced attack, more of a run first style of offense. And guess what? They finished the season at 8-8. And then, what happened the following year? They won the Super Bowl. And so from there, you can see that having a balanced offensive attack is really the key. And you can say, yes, this is definitely, most definitely, it's a quarterback-driven league nowadays. I understand that. But the one thing that has remained true even today is that you still have to have a strong running game. And if you don't have a strong running game, you're going to become one-dimensional. Then it's going to be easy for the defense to pin their ears back and come after your quarterback. And that's just the facts, folks. You got to have a strong running game. And sometimes that running game doesn't look like the traditional running game, but you have to have a balanced attack. And Washington right now needs to have a balanced attack. They got plenty of talent in the backfield. You've got Brian Robinson Jr., who's going to have an exciting career, I believe. You got Antonio Gibson. You got J.D. McKissick. I mean, you got guys like that who can run the rock. So let them run the rock. You got to do this. You got to scrap everything. You got to look at your team and say, we're 1-4. Something has to change. And I believe if they think at all that they have a season that they can salvage, it starts Thursday night, and it starts against the Chicago Bears. And I think that if they don't make some major changes to their offensive philosophy, the season's done. At 1-5, you're done. I mean, that's just it. You cannot come back. People seem to think adding one extra game to the season makes all the difference in the world. Not when you're 1-5. I'm sorry. You're just not going to win the rest of your football games. Especially not when you're playing in a division that right now is probably one of the best divisions in the league. Wasn't like that a couple of years ago. You could say a couple of years ago you're at 1-5 and you still have a chance to win the NFC East. You can't say that this year. The NFC East is actually really good. So let's see what happens, folks. Chicago Bears, they're 2-3. Washington Commanders, they're 1-4. What's going to happen? Let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, then like it. Put a thumbs up on it. And give me a comment. Let me know what you think. What's going to happen Thursday night? And as well, share this with your buddies. Share it with your Chicago Bear fans buddies. Let me know what they think. And again, if you are enjoying this channel, then why not subscribe? It's free. Subscribe to me, please, and hit that notification bell so you'll know when I come out with another video release. As well, if you want to support this channel, you can do so by going to my Patreon page. I promise I am trying to revamp that page. I'm only doing $3 memberships. $3, that's it, $3. Just go to Starbucks one day less. I mean, come on. You can do that, can't you? You could also support me by donating directly to me through Venmo, through Cash App. I'll show you. Can't seem to get out. But something deep inside won't let me quit. I swear.